द्वैपायनो विरह कातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयमाम चरणान्ति भक्त्या विहीना अपराधलक्ष्यै चेप्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दम् I'm very happy that you from different parts of America and here and there you have assembled here. I want to request first thing that if you want to increase your bhakti, then try to give superiors
honor
and respect. I think that from tomorrow, the senior devotees and disciples of Swamiji, Bhaktivedanta Swamiji, they should given preference to sit forward. If you see them, do pranam and tell them, oh, you should be first. Not only here sitting, give preference where prasadam is given also. Where sitting, prasadam, everywhere. In India, we give respect. Oh, this is my senior, seniorest. Like this. Seniorest should be in right side. And thus giving proper respect to all. Here, I'm not saying here this. Oh, junior devotees, they should be careful if they want bhakti. They should give honor and tell, oh Prabhu, you should be in front in this way. So from tomorrow, the senior most and seniors, devotees of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swamiji, they are like my god brothers. They should be respected and given chance here. In similar case, in lady devotees, they should be given chance. This is the first thing. That is okay. They should be there.
Those who are sitting in chairs.
Eh?
Those who are sitting in chairs, they should sit in the back.
Yes.
Otherwise they block the way for other devotees.
Chair wala? They should be in any side. Today, but next, you should see anywhere inside that there should be no
blockage.
When we do archan, we begin archan from Gurudev, not from Krishna. No? Why?
It's not loud enough. In the bed.
So you should make arrangement. Oh, the manager should be try to make arrangement. You should make arrangement that everywhere. You can keep two, three like this.
Speakers are here, so this one.
No? Two, three.
Sorry, one speaker.
In the middle also or in the end, so that all can hear. You should remind them if anything, any problem. Here?
Yeah.
Here. It will do? Now it will do? You are hearing now? So, first Guru Puja and anything. So, I want to speak on Chaitanya Chaitamrita. And in Chaitanya Charitamrita we see Bande Gurun Isham Ishavatar Kana Tat Prakashap Tat Sakti Krishna Chaitanya Sangakam. Or the first slok begins from here. This is Mangala Charanam. What is Mangala Charanam? Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami has told. Oh, from ancient time, from Vyas, in Vedas also. First Mangala Charanam. To do pranam to their Ishtadev, Gurudev, Ishtadev. Oh, so that he can complete that thing what he is going to begin. Here, in Chaitanya Charitamritam, he has done Mangalacharanam from here. Bande Gurun. This is the first lok of Chaitanya Chaitamrita. Those who have no Guru Nishtha, oh, they can enter in Bhakti realm. Guru Nishtha is the backbone of Bhakti. Of all wealths and goods, this Guru Nishtha. If you cannot obey your Guru, you have no faith on your Guru, then everything your is what? Bogus. So it is fruitless. So our Guru Nishtha. If Guru told that you should stand here, oh, stand up here. Like Valmiki, he told his Narada, told that you should be here. And he was here for 60,000 years there. No drinking, no eating, no passing stalls and urine, nothing. He forget that this body is mine. And thus he realized so by the mercy of his Gurudev. So, if you want to develop your Krishna consciousness, then you have put a strong faith on your Guru. Krishna is afterward. If Krishna is angry by your any activities, but Guru is happy, then jasya prasadat bhagavat prasado, jasya aprasadan nagati kutopi. Guru can save you from Krishna, but Krishna cannot save from Krishna.
Guru.
So, Guru is a so high class of tattva. Guru can give Krishna Radha. Krishna himself will not give you. He will not come to you. But Guru, in the form of Guru, Krishna himself coming. So he is doing Vandana. Bande Gurun. He has told he Guru, but not in singular number. Why he told? Oh. The Guru, the forms of Guru, of Krishna, are in several ways. Diksha Guru, Shiksha Guru, O Chaitya Guru, Vatma Pradarshak Guru, oh, so many Gurus. And all are prominent. But in them, O Diksha Guru, and Shiksha Guru are more prominent. Chaitanya Guru himself Krishna, but he is telling himself that, oh, Diksha Guru and Shiksha Guru. In these two Guru, all comes. So these two words are comprehensive. So Gurun, Diksha Guru, Shiksha Guru, then Chaitya Guru. I think that Chaitya Guru is first. If Chaitya Guru not inspiring you to go to Diksha Guru, you cannot go. So, first Diksha Guru, Chaitya Guru, and then Vaishnavas are Guru, all the Vaishnava high class. In their association, you will know all these tattvas. Then Vaishnavas, and then Diksha Guru, Shiksha Guru, and other Gurus. So he is describing all. Mantra Guru are Jata Shiksha Guru Gan. Tahana Charana Age Korei Bandhan. What he has told? Have you this book?
Yes, which number was
good? What Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj has written? Oh, 35.
Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Adilila Chapter 1, Text 35. Translation by Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada.
Or some are telling that Narayan Maharaj is not in the line of Swamiji. I don't know why they tell, but I always follow Swamiji. First Swamiji preference. They are not following, but even they are telling that, oh, he is not following in his line. But I am saying that they are not in line. They don't follow. Everywhere I follow Swamiji. So he is telling what?
I first offer my respectful obeisances at the lotus feet of my initiating spiritual master and to all of my instructing spiritual masters.
But after that he is taking the names of his Shiksha Guru, not Diksha Guru. Why, I don't know. You can think over this matter. Sri Rup Sanatan Bhatta Raghunath, Sri Jiv Gopal Bhatta Das Raghunath, Echaya Guru Shiksha Guru Jayamar, Tasavar Patpatme Koti Namaskar.
The instructing spiritual masters are Sri Rupa Goswami, Sri Sanatana Goswami, Sri Bhatta Raghunath, Sri Jiva Goswami, Sri Gopal Bhatta Goswami, and Sri Raghunath Das Goswami. These six are my Shiksha Gurus, my instructing spiritual masters, and therefore I offer millions of respectful obeisances unto their lotus feet.
Well, where he is Diksha Guru here? He has he mentioned his Diksha Guru?
No.
Anywhere? But I know. Perhaps you don't know. Who was? When he was in house, family life, or his brother was the master of the family, and there was a big festival there. And so many devotees were there. Abhiram Thakur there also came. He was very interested for Nityananda Prabhu. Having a, what, flute, and having some...
Stick.
Hunter-like. And when the festival was going on, Abhiram Thakur came, and he was glorifying Nityananda Prabhu, Nityananda Prabhu.
To whom he will beat by the stick, they will get Krishna.
And to whom he
mercifully
was merciful, or at once used to give hunter. Mm-hmm. And Krishna Prem used to come. This was his process. Like Narada Rishi sometimes used to become angry and to give some curse. And thus giving what? Krishna bhakti. Like Nalkobar Manigriv, he became angry and he gave curse, but at once he gave what? Krishna bhakti, pure Krishna bhakti. So here he is telling, Sri Rup Sanatan Bhatta Raghunath, Sri Jiv Gopal Bhatta Das Raghunath.
You were telling who was the Diksha Guru.
And there Abhiram Goswami came and he was glorifying Nityananda Prabhu. Oh, his brother became somewhat upset. And his guru was somewhat very interested for Mahaprabhu, but not honor for Nityananda Prabhu. Perhaps you don't know why. Because they cannot reconcile Nityananda Prabhu character. Why he left Brahmachari ashram and he took two wives? They don't know that Baldev Prabhu is Nityananda Prabhu. So they think that, oh, he is bad character of person. He is not. Ordinary devotees, even what to tell himself God.
He is Bhagavat Tattva, Nityananda.
So they were not honoring him like that. And that is why they don't wanted to glorify Nityananda Prabhu. They wanted to glorify only Mahaprabhu. And these are Ardha Kukkuti Nyaya. What Ardha Kukkuti Nyaya?
This is called the logic of half a hen.
What is the meaning?
The meaning is that someone thinks, I have a chicken.
Kukkut,
Ardha Kukkuti Nyaya. I have a chicken and the back part of the chicken gives me eggs. But the front part of the chicken, very expensive, I have to feed. So if I cut my chicken in half, I won't have to feed the front part and I'll take the eggs from the back part. It's called Ardha Kukkuti Nyaya, the logic of
half
a hen.
If you cut that hen, I want only second part, not first part. And if you are cutting, then what will be? She will not give any aid. Oh, she will die. So if you are not honoring Nityananda Prabhu and you are honoring Mahaprabhu, then everything is your.
Go in vain.
Zero.
In vain. Nothing will come. So Abhiram Thakur was disturbed. Why you are glorifying Nityananda Prabhu? Nityananda, not Prabhu. You should glorify only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then he became angry. And he
broke his flute and went away.
And then he left this place. Then this Kaviraj Goswami also became very angry. I don't like a brother and guru like that. And he gave up. And he left at once. And he came out of the village to go to Vrindavan. And he decided mind that, oh, I must give up. So when he was out of the village, at once he was in dream.
Under a tree.
And Nityananda Prabhu came. And he accepted. Oh, for me you have given up your guru and
brother.
And put his lotus feet on the head of Kaviraj Goswami.
And then he kept his lotus feet on the head. Oh, I will do everything. You should go to Vrindavan. And he sent and he is accepting Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami that by the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, I came to Vrindavan. Oh, I met with Rupa and Sanatan. And by the grace of Nityananda Prabhu, I received the shower of the mercy of Rupa and Sanatan, Madan Mohan Govinda Gopinath. I saw them all, I took darshan, and I have bhakti. What bhakti? From Nityananda Prabhu. So his guru, he rejected. Original cool guru. And he came to Rupa Sanatan, Rupa Raghunath. Especially he has told all, but always he has, in the last of these all chapters, what he has done. Sri Rupa Raghunath, Jahar Ash, Chaitanya Charitamrit Kahe Krishna Das everywhere. So really his guru is Rupa Raghunath, both. In Rupa Raghunath, he preferred to both, not he divided them. Rupa and Raghunath are not divided, undivided Guru Tattva. So this, in this way, you should try to understand, give respect properly to Guru. Echaya Guru, Siksha Guru Jamar. What is the difference between Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru? He has told afterward, Guru Krishna Rupan, Diksha Guru Rupan, Shastra Pramane. Shastra says, who is Shastra? Krishna himself is Shastra. The wordings of Krishna are Shastra. All the Ved, Puran, Vedanta, and all we see, Srimad Bhagavatam, these are the word of Krishna himself. None difference to Krishna. Sometimes Krishna comes, but Shastra we can see. But even by reading you cannot realize. Ja Bhagavata Rakache. Bhagavata Pada. If you want to read Bhagavatam and to hear, you should go to Bhagavatam. One is Bhakti Rasa Patra. Srimad Bhagavatam as a granth, as a book, transcendental book, containing all kinds of ras, bhakti, rasamrita, sindhu. But it is in lock and key. Guru has the key and he can open it. So he must be Bhagavat, Mahabhagavat. Otherwise, not Guru. We are a septic, not a high class of Guru like Bhagavata or Mahabhagavata. That is why bogus Guru falls down. And then we become upset. Oh, this is our fault. We should try to know really who is Guru. Shastra has told. So Shastra, Guru Krishna Rupan Shastra Rapramane. To suffer the mercy, Krishna has taken the shape of Guru. So Guru Krishna Rupan Diksha Guru. Guru is what? Form of Guru. Condensed form.
Form of Krishna.
In condensed form. But what is Siksha Guru? Who is Siksha Guru? Siksha Guru ke jani Krishna ra swarup. Swarup of Krishna. Siksha Guru. More intimate. Siksha Guru. Siksha Guru is not less than Diksha Guru. Oh, if Sanatana Goswami is Sambandha Gyan Data, Diksha Guru, and Rupa Goswami is Siksha Guru, giving all kinds of teaching of Krishna and process of having Krishna Prem, who is superior? Rupa Goswami or Sanatana Goswami? No superiority, no genuity. But even there is Vaishishtya.
Speciality.
Oh, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has suffered Rupa Goswami, inspired Rupa Goswami. What is he has in his heart? Everything. And that is why Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Thapitang Jaina Bhutale Swayang Rupah Kada Dadati Vishwa. He has told. For Sanatana Goswami also it has been told. Vairagya Bhakti Yugarasam Vairagya bhakti.
Vairagya bhakti rasampradaya prayatnaya
paayana manu manabhipshamandam kripam buddhirija paradukkho dukhe. But yet Rasa, Sanatana Goswami also respects Rupa Goswami like a guru. Though Sanatana Goswami is guru of Rupa Goswami. But even, Srila Sanatana Goswami has given what more importance to Srila Rupa Goswami. Ad-dana-strenam dante ra puna puna shimadarupadam bhojudholi shat janman janmani. In this way, but nowadays, Shiksha Guru, to give Shiksha Guru importance somewhat, it is like Bhagavat Parampara. And if you are respecting only Diksha Guru, not Shiksha Guru, then really you are not Bhagavat Parampara, as Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami has told. He has taken Bhagavat Parampara. And Guru Parampara is including in
Bhagavat Parampara.
In Bhagavat Parampara. Guru Parampara sometimes not
included.
Not so
pure. No? But Bhagavat Parampara always pure. How?
You know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never gave any diksha to anyone. Never gave. But Rupa Sanatan are praying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Guru. Any diksha Guru cannot help his disciple, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu inspired all things in Rupa and Sanatana. So really they are Guru. They are disciples of Mahaprabhu. Everywhere they have done pranam to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as their Gurus. Though they have not been initiated, and false sacrifice was done in their calculation. Fire sacrifice, fire and all these things giving, putting Brahma Upanayanitya. Not so much important. What is important? To give pure bhakti in the heart of the devotee. So he is telling first. We will come afterward. Sri Rupa Sanatan Bhatta Raghunath, Sri Jiva Gopal Bhatta Das Raghunath, Echhai Guru Shiksha Guru Ji Amar, Tasabar Pad Padme Koti Namaskar. What he is telling? You have told?
Yes, I have told.
Bhagavaner Bhakta Jata Sivasadi Pradhan, Tahara Pad Padme Sahasta Pranar. What?
There are innumerable devotees of the Lord.
Srinivas Thakur is the foremost. I offer my respectful obeisances thousands of times unto their lotus feet.
Why he is telling the word Isha Bhaktan Srivasadi Bhakta Brinda. For this is making meaning here. All the bhaks, like Srivas Pandit. Srivas Pandit is Narad Goswami. Oh, Narad Goswami, you know, very tricky. Oh, very hard to calculate
his character.
His character. Very high class of. In each world with Krishna answer, Water.
Each time Krishna makes an expansion.
And with all expansion, he is there.
Serving.
In Vaikuntha, in this world, in Swarga, in heaven, in Brahma Lok, in Krishna Lok, in Narayan Lok, Ajodhya, or Vrindavan. And in Vrindavan, he is like who? Madhu Mangal.
Narada Gopi.
And Narada Gopi. Or so many forms he has. Like Krishna. So Shivas is like that. So if you are not respecting, honoring Vaishnava, only Guru Diksha Guru. I know my Diksha Guru. If he will tell to kill anyone for my rival, oh, he is my disciple. You should go and beat. Give lessons. Those who are coming here.
Other gurus.
Other gurus, disciples. So you can beat them, yes. Kill them, you can do it. What is this nonsense?
Bogus.
So we should try to respect all the Vaishnavas. From beginning, Kanishta Adhikari, Madhyam Adhikari, Uttam Adhikari, all we should try to honor. One kirtan. Oh, Prabhu, one kirtan. Because all are asleep.
Hare Krishna kirtan?
Oh. Gauranga.
Gauranga bolite hobe pulaka sharira Hari Hari vipale nayane bhavani
explaining about Sadguru. If there is Sadguru, then Asadguru may be there. So you should be very careful for Asadguru, those who are not really Guru, but they think that we are Guru. Here we should know Shastra, Krishna words. Tasmat Gurum Prapadyeta Jigyasu Shreya Uttamam Shabde Parecha Nishanatam Brahmanyu Pasamashayam. Tasmat. Why tasmat? Oh, then. Tasmat means then. Oh. When and then? Two words in Hindi or Sanskrit. Jab, tab. Kya hota hai jab, ab, tab?
When.
When this happens, then this also happens.
In English, not so clear, but in Hindi and Sanskrit. Why tasmat has come? That is, if you are in world, always in distress, in problem, suffering and all these things. You are wealthy, a rich person, very beautiful, very strong body. Even you will have to be old, surely. And you will have to die. This world is like a jail. Who has forgotten Krishna? The absent by Yog Maya to this?
Mahamaya.
Mahamaya, this Mahamaya is jail. Don't search happiness in this world. If you aren't going to happy, oh, then you should chant, remember Krishna and follow Shastra. So this place is made of sufferings and sorrow, difficulties and problems. If you are seeking happiness in this world, oh, you are bogus, any animal like donkeys and what?
Monkeys
and hogs and pigs. So you should have very strong faith in Shastra. Tasmat. So if you want to know, Shreyaha. Shreya means, what is in this world is Shreya. Only Krishna Bhakti is Shreya. All the wealth, reputations, worldly things, loves in this world, all are bogus things. For whom we are running after. They cannot give even a very small
particles
of sukh, happiness. Then you should go to whom? Gurum prapadyet. You should go to real guru. Then disciples ask, who is the real guru? Then Shastra tells, what? Sabde parecha nishnatam. He should know all the Vedas, all the scriptures, Puran, Shastra, Ved, Vedanta, everything. He should be expert. If guru is not expert in all these things, oh, he should not be taken as a guru. He should reject. If he is expert in all Vedas, Shastra, Srimad Bhagavatam, and all are in his
throat.
He remembers all, but he has no realization of Para, Krishna, Supreme Personality of Krishna. Krishna is so beautiful. He is so sweet. He is so charming. Playing on flute, looking from the crooked eyes. He is weeping. He is walking.
Sweet.
Everything sweet. His separation mood is also so sweet. Meeting mood, so sweet. Oh, his mother is sweet. His brother is sweet. His Mathura is sweet. His Vrindavan is sweet. His all the Shakti powers, like Lalita Abhishekha, is sweet. Chandravali are very sweet. But most sweet who? Srimati Radhika. So, taking all, Krishna is there. So, if he want to know, to select a guru, he should be realized for this. If I have no realization, Krishna, with what I told, then he should not be taken guru. Even all the Shastras are here. He knows, he is expert, so much expert. He can
recite
all these things. But if he has no realization of Krishna, or Krishna associates his dham, or Jamuna, Govardhan, Radhakund, Shyamkund, all, he has no realization. Oh, you should try to reject. And if you are not rejecting, oh, you will be cheated, and you are cheated. Keep always this mind. So here two kinds of symptoms have been given. One, Swarup, and second is
Tatastha.
What is? These two are somewhat like Sarup. Sarup symptom. But Upasamasrayam, if he is expert in all Vedas, and with that he has realized soul of Krishna Tattva, Radha Tattva, Bhakti Tattva, Rasa Tattva, Maya Tattva, all he is expert. And he has some realization. He must be renounced.
Detached
from worldly desires. He must be. But yet it is Mayabadi sannyasi can also be like detached. But they are not having realization of God. That is why they are telling that, oh, Krishna is shapeless, oh, beautyless, Oh, nirgun.
Qualityless.
Oh, nirshakti.
No
power. No power, no attribute, nothing. He is like zero, like Buddhism. So we should reject them. But even, oh, then he is telling, he is, usko emphasis de karke kah rahe hain. He is telling,
it's emphasis.
Important.
Something more. In other words, tad vijnanartham guru meva bhigachet samatpani sotriyam brahmanistham. What? Same thing, but in
different.
Other word. If you want to know vijnanam or some sleepiness is coming and your eyes are so heavy, then you should try to sit like this. If you are like this, then your eye will be reddish and you will like this. So I am requesting you to sit like this old man, person, or like this. Oh, why you are sitting? Then first, Maya will send his daughters. Do you know who are daughters?
Yoni.
And then his son.
His sister.
You know his son? Or daughter. Oh, Nidra is daughter. Means sleepiness. So be careful. If you are not like this, all words cannot go into your ears. And then how to follow? So his next, by next slok he is
emphasis.
What? Tad vijnanartham. Tad means Krishna. Who Krishna? That I told you. Aradhyo Bhagavan Praje Satanaya Taddham Vrindavanam Ramya Kachyutupasana Bajubadhu Bargena Jakalpita Shrimad Bhagavatam Purana Amalam Purmartho Mahan Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhur Tathagaruna Parah. Oh, Krishna like this. Not Mathuresh Krishna. Not Dwarkesh Krishna. Oh, without float, without Radhika, without yes. And also rejecting father, mother, Nanda and Jashoda, and he has accepted, oh, my father is who? Vasudev, mother? Oh, I am of Mathura. Reject them. Then, oh, Krishna is Aradhyo Bhagavan Prajeshatan. Always living in Vrindavan.
Not in Dwarka.
Chastising by whom? Mother Yashoda. She can bind him and twist his. Or sit down. Oh, you.
Stand up. You're not.
And what doing more? Oh, massaging the feet of? Gopis. Oh, this really Krishna is Krishna. So he is Aradhyo Bhagavan. And Aradhana of Gopis is superior, most superior. Ramya Kachyutu Parsana Bajubadhvari. The Gopis, oh, rendering service to Krishna. How? Oh, massage my feet. And then how? Oh, they will put Krishna, oh, you should put collar in my feet. And what do? They will give impression that, oh, in him. Then you will be known as Krishna. Otherwise, Vrajeshanandan. Otherwise, not. Oh, this Krishna. So if you want to know and have big gyan, vishesh gyan, love and affection of Braja, then you should go to Guru. High class of Guru. What is the symptom of the Guru? Guru? Samit Pani. Don't go empty-handed. Better you should take your heart in your hands. Your heart. Heart should be pure. And take and give it in the feet of your Gurudev. Then you can go. I will not disobey you. Prabhu, I want Krishna Prem. I want a Braja Prem. So that is big gyan. For this, you should go to Guru. And what is the same time? Kshatriyam Brahmanishtam. He should know all the epics, Ved, Upanishad, Puran, what I told. Especially Srimad Bhagavatam. He should be master of Srimad Bhagavatam. And secondly, man, first that, as second is this. If he is expert in all, but not realization of Brahma Nishtham, he has no Nishtha par Brahma, para Brahma. And that is why, you know, the history of Vyasadeva. He was expert in our Vedanta. He wrote Vedanta and he expressed Mahabharata, Gita, Sarvadharman, Parityajyamam, Ekam Sharanam Braja. But he was not satisfied what he has done. When he became satisfied, by the help of his Guru Narada Rishi, and then he saw, Krishna was in Kunj of Vrindavan, in Kunj of Govardhan, he saw that Krishna is messaging. Oh, be pleased. Keep your feet
on my head.
On my
head.
Who is praying? Supreme. That Rashik, Rashikendra Shekhara. Krishna. That Krishna. And he saw so many things. He saw Rosh. He saw the birth of Krishna in Gokul. And everything he realized. So this is Brahmanishtam. If a guru is not Brahmanishtam, having no realization of Krishna and not knowing and realizing all these things. Like Narad, like Sukadeva Goswami, like third Narad. They cannot give you Krishna prem. They will fall down. No realization. They know only some slokes, not fully reading Shastra from any Gurudev. How can they give all these things? They can never give up, give these things. They cannot reconcile two slokes which are outwardly
contradictory.
They cannot. They have no faith in Guru words, in Shastra, and no realization. So it has been told what? Jasya Deve Parabhakti. It has been written in Ved. Jasya Deve Parabhakti. Jatha Deve Tatha Guru. He has so much Nishtha in Guru, Krishna. More Nishtha in Gurudev. Jasya Deve Parabhakti. In Krishna Parabhakti, Prema Bhakti. And Gurudev, more than this. Oh, he is called Guru. If that Guru is pleased, he will tell only, oh, my mercy is there. You should realize that Rashik Krishna in Vrindavan with Radhika. Who is first Narad? Who gave up his mother, he was going to die, he died, and he left, he ran away in the forest. And what he has received, the diksha from his Gurudev, Sanakshanandan, Sanatan, Sanat Kumar. And he went there, and he was practicing Bhakti Yoga. And he was so much weeping and crying for Krishna, that Krishna could not control. And for a moment, like a thunderbolt, he gave darshan, jhanki darshan to Narad. At that time, Narad was a 5 years aged boy. And again, disappeared. Then he began to weep more louder. Then Ariel voice came and told that, I cannot give you darshan. No. In this body, This body is made of what? Of karma that you did in past years. And you have some thing that you have some desire. And that desire is what? I want to be a very lonely place and to chant and remember. It means he was not fully surrendered. That is why Krishna refused to give darshan. And he told that you should go on practicing bhakti yoga, and now you should go everywhere and chant, remember, and you can make disciples and help others. In this stage, he met with Vyasadeva, Valmiki, Prahlad, and all others. He touched only. And how they became, you know? So he is Guru. These Gurus are called Murchit Kashar. What is Murchit Kashar? What is Murchit Kashar? You.
Murchit Kashar.
Oh, you are sleeping. Don't sleep. Murchit Kashar means?
There are three types of Uttam Adhikari Mahabhava devotees. They're called Murchit Kasai, Nirduk Kasai, and Bhagat Parshad Dehaprat. The first stage, known as Murchit Kasai, they have a material body in this world, composed of the fruits of their previous karma. But now, by their practice of bhakti, they become so powerful, and almost all their anarthas have gone. But still something remains.
Not gone. But they are there, but they are sleeping.
Something
they can sometimes may
woke up
and work.
So murchit means fainted. Some anatta is there, but now it is not active in any way by the strength of their bhakti. So this is called murchit.
But by chance they can come out, like Bharat Maharaj. Oh, it came and what he did? For three births he lost. He fell down for three. For our training. And then second?
So the example of the first type of Uttam Adhikari, Murchit Kasai, is Narad Rishi in his previous life, in the life in which he received mantra and instructions from the four Kumars, and in which he had darshan of the Supreme Lord once. This is called Murchit Kasai. He had some desire. He wanted to live in a peaceful place in the forest. Then the next category is called Nirdhut Kasai. Nirdhut Kasai means they have no contamination at all. Though their body is material and their body is in this world, yet their heart is completely cleansed. So Nirdhut means completely washed clean. The example of the devotee in this category is Sukadev Goswami. Then the third category is called Bhagavat Parshada Dehaprat. Those who have attained that body in which they are an associate of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Their body is not material, it is not made of karma fall. It is transcendental. The example of this is Narad Rishi in this life, as he is as Narad. At the end of his previous life, when he met with death, at that time he gave up that body and received a transcendental body in which he can go from the spiritual to this world and back without any impediment. So this is called Bhagavat Parshada Deha Prapt.
Oh, like them, in this world, very rare gurus. Only Madhyam Adhikari we can find. Not Mahabhagavat Uttam like Narad, Sukadeva Goswami, and very, if Krishna mercifully can send them, they can come. Or Krishna can come in having a shape of Guru. Usually in this world, O Madhya Mahadhikari becomes Guru. If any Mahabhagavat becomes Guru, except disciples, oh, he will come in the stage of Madhya Mahadhikari also. This is the symptom of Madhya Mahadhikari. What? prema maitri kripa paksha ja karoti sam madhyama. He has so uttam adhikari has no function. He can do anything he like. In any way he can serve his Krishna. And Kanishtha adhikari has no division of all these things. Only statue worshipping, no so much honor for Vaishnavas, not knowing expert in Shastra, no realization of Krishna. So he is called Kanishtha. He has duty for this Kanishtha adhikari that has been told. One of the duties of Madhyama adhikari has told, prema, maitri, kripa, upeksha. So if Madhyama adhikari is there, guru, no harm, but he should be sincere and he should be touching Uttam Bhagavat stage. Madhyam Uttam, not Madhyam Kanishta. Never. He cannot give. Some semblance, avas, oh, that guru can give. Madhyam Uttam. He is going to touch or enter Uttam Adhikar. He can. So if guru is like that, then he can give her so much help, otherwise not. But if any Madhyam Adhikari Guru, even being, if Kanishtha Adhikari is imposing that I am Guru, or he is fallen from beginning, he is posing like Guru, for ignorant person, oh, he can be Guru. But oh, if Guru avaliptasya, Karja karja majanata utpat pratipannasya pratyagoy evo vidhiyate. If a Kanishtha adhikari or Madhyam adhikari, even he thinks that I am Guru, really, I am Guru of Guru. But avaliptasya karja karja majanata, what to do and what to not do, he does not know. He is not now in the line of his Gurudev. No? He is doing some offenses in the lotus feet of Vaishnavas, not proper respecting. Then, what we should do? Parityage eva vidhiyate. At once, reject him. If he cannot give the realization of Krishna, he is not expert in all Shastra, he is not detached from worldly desires, no? Then he should be rejected at once. If you are not rejecting, oh, he is my very dear, how I can give up? Oh, my institution will be
ruined, destroyed.
Destroyed. Oh, then you are very far away for transcendental all these things. So be careful. At once give up that guru. If in your ignorance, or if you have accepted paramartha, that in which no paramartha. Paramartha means transcendental.
Transcendental wealth.
Oh, if he is not paramarthic, he is laukik guru, you know?
Worldly. Like family guru.
Family guru.
Worldly.
He may be very expert in worldly behaviors, and he is quite ajogya.
Unqualified
transcendental things. Oh, you should at once reject without a minute delay. If you have accepted, even you can pray, oh Gurudev, oh, can you give up, give this Krishna Bhakti to me, and not then reject him. You should do pranam. Oh, I want to go to that guru, associate. If he orders that, oh, very good, I am happy, I am also coming, then he is really somewhat sincere. And you should respect him. but go to superiors. And then pray, I want Shreya. I want to serve Krishna. I want Krishna love and affection. Please help me. Surrender. And if not doing, no bhakti. Like what he has told that. That is no Krishna prem. Then your all efforts will go in vain. Shastra is telling. And that is why Srila Jiva Goswami is telling, Guru Rapi Avaliptasya Karja Karjam Majanata Utpatapati Pannasya Parityagva. We should at once reject that Guru. And we should do Paramarthik Guru who can give this Krishna Prem. Expert in three. Expert in detachment from world. And second, he should be expert in all Shastra. And thirdly, he should have. So, Abhaisna Mukhat Girina. Abhaisna Padeshtena Mantrena Nirayam Brajeta. If your Guru is not qualified and you have accepted anyhow wrongly, then by that you go to hell. So better Punascha Vidhina Samyak Grahyeta Vaishnavadu. Then you should take initiation from a Vaishnava, really Vaishnava Guru. Tadvidhi Pranipatena Pariprasnena Sevaya. And then you should go to real Guru. And tadvidhi pranipatena. Tadvidhi means you should know Krishna by pranipat, unconditional surrendering. Pariprasnena, very mildly, submissive. Submissive way. Gurudev, I want to know this. If I am qualified to know, please tell me in this way. And sevaya, if not sevaya, and by word you are telling that I am surrendered, it will not do. Guru may tell something, but you cannot realize, and at that time sleepness will come, idleness will come, and you cannot realize. Gaur Premanand. One Kirtan, Prabhu. One Kirtan.